assumptions before we even proceed. Just like in kinetic theory of gases, we had what? List of assumptions. Then only we worked further. So write down the assumptions. Assumption number one. Assumption number one is, you know, electrons are moving freely inside the metal unless they encounter a collision. What does it mean? What does it mean? Between two collisions, speed is constant. Why? Because there is no force between two collisions. Only force that can come is because of collision. Because of collision. Fine? Are you getting it? Net electric field, we are assuming that it is not influencing the motion of electron. Okay? We are saying that, you know, that if it is between the two collisions, there is nothing that can influence its motion. Okay? But if you apply an electric field, then what will happen? Between two collisions, electric field can influence the motion. So between two collisions, only electric field can apply a force. Clear?
Sir, why is this an assumption? Shouldn't it be just...
What
else could it be? Like, it will obviously be freely.
So see, there can be a nucleus which can affect. There can be, the charge is there, right? So other electron charge can influence. Okay? So it may get influenced. There might be some dipole moment inside itself. Okay? But then we are ignoring all that. And in fact, it's a good approximation also, you know, because these influences are very, very small. Okay? Compared to what speed it has. Right? Now write down next assumption. Next assumption is, just after a collision, what will happen to velocity of electron just after a collision? Can you predict its direction?
No.
So it is random. Just after collision, the velocity of electron is random. Fine? Are you getting it?
Yes.
That's the assumption. Okay? If electron collides with any other particle inside, its velocity becomes random. Even if there is electric field. Even if there is an electric field. Are you getting it? Because the kind of force it will experience because of collision, that will be very high compared to what electric field can apply the force on it. So it, because of collision, there is impulsive force. Okay? And the electric field force is a smooth force. That will be almost nothing compared to the impulse it gets due to the collision. Fine? So when you take the average velocity of the electron just after collision, how much it will be? Zero. Zero. So what happens? Electron moves like this. It hits something. Average velocity becomes zero. Then what happens? Between the next collision and just after the first collision, it tries to move along the direction of electric field. And then again it collides. And again velocity becomes random. Are you getting it? Are you getting my point here? What? So between two collisions, it will try to move along the direction of electric field. But as soon as collision happens, it becomes random. Are you getting? Now, so if time between the two collisions is more, will that favor the flow of charge? Yes or no?
Yeah.
Right? Isn't it? But if collision frequency increases, the more it collides, more the velocity becomes random. So it will not be able to move in a particular direction. Fine? And that is the reason why when you increase the temperature, what happens? It starts to move in rightful direction. Although its velocity becomes, magnitude velocity becomes high. But since it becomes random, more and more collisions. Okay? So it becomes unfavorable most of the time. Increasing temperature. So resistance goes up. Are you getting it? Fine. So let us try to use these assumptions and find the value of resistivity in terms of the micro factors. Okay? So write down, our analysis is just between the two collisions. Because as soon as a collision happens, things become random. Fine? So write down, between two collisions, as in just after first collision. See, first collision need not be the, you know, initial collision. I'm saying the, you know, first collision and then next collision, like that. So this is just after first collision and just before second collision. What happens? That is what I'm studying. Any doubt on this? Okay? Because between this only, between the two collision only, electric field can influence. Okay? So if I understand what happens between two collisions, I can take average of whatever happens in between all two collisions. Are you getting it? Okay? So let us try to do that. What is the acceleration of electron between two collisions? Electric field into charge of electron divided by mass of electron. So acceleration is E by M. Write this down. This is acceleration between the two collisions. Okay? So is this constant acceleration between two collisions? Is acceleration constant?
Yes.
It is constant. So I can use V is equal to U plus AT? Yes or no?
Yeah.
I can find that. So V is equal to U plus AT. This is a vector equation. What is going on?
So, is acceleration between two collisions constant between the two collisions, or is it constant throughout?
It is constant between the two collisions, because when it hits the net, when there is a collision, that will also apply some force. Fine.
No,
so that.
But the right hand side of that expression is a constant, right? So
no, I'm talking about between two collisions. The collision is not happening between these two. Okay? As soon as collision happens, the collision also creates some sort of acceleration.
Yeah.
Okay? Any other doubt? Any other doubt, please clear. No doubt. Okay? So V is equal to U plus AT. Now, what is this U? What is this U? U is the velocity just after first collision. It is a vector. It is a vector, okay? What is this V? Just before the next collision. And this is what? T. Time between the two collisions. Fine? This is only for one electron. Okay? Let me substitute the values. Here it will be V is equal to U minus EE by M times T. So I will get a vector equation like this. There will be minus here because electron will experience force in opposite direction of electric field. Okay. Now let us take the average of all. Because the current is due to all the free electrons. It is not because of just one electron. Fine? So when you take average, this is the symbol for average. Okay? V average, average of U minus EE by N is constant. So I will just take average of T. Is T also constant?
Time
between two collisions, is it constant?
No.
It is not constant. There is no reason it should be constant. There may be one collision in 1 millisecond. Other collision could be 10 milliseconds. And imagine there are millions of electrons. Fine? So So you're taking average of all the times between the two collisions.
That
is average. Huh? Yeah. That. You know, there has to be some symbol for representing the first. So we are using that. So this means average. Okay. Is this nice or not? You want to use something else?
Nice. So you made.
No, I'm not. Who am I?
Then how can we change? Huh? Just take something.
No, I can change it for you.
No problem.
Okay, so if you take average, what happens to average of U? What happens to this average?
Zero.
It is zero. What is average of time? This becomes tau G. This is tau. This is what? This is velocity just after first collision. And we already learned that that is a presumption. It should be random just after collision. Random meaning, if one goes in positive x direction, okay, one electron suppose goes in positive x direction, there is a chance that other goes in negative x direction. What is this average? Why you have to talk to each other? When I take average, what I am doing? I am taking average for all the electrons' movement. If one goes in this way, this is not a preferred direction after collision. It just happens to be. There is a chance that it goes this way. So there is equal probability that other electron will go that way. So probabilities are equal. It is random. So that is why net all the velocity when you add up becomes zero. Fine. So you are taking vector average. You are not finding magnitude and then taking average. Are you getting your point? Okay. Now tell me, what is the vector average of V? Now see, this velocity will have two components. One component will be random.
Other will be along.
Other will be
along
E. Okay. So when you take average, the random component average becomes zero. So it is gone. Okay, so whatever comes out, let us call it as drift velocity. This is random and along E. Pardon my handwriting. Now I am recording also, so my handwriting should be better. So random and along E.
That is the velocity of electron.
This is the velocity just before the second collision. So, what happens between the first and the next collision, random is anywhere there, but electric field also influences its velocity. So I am separating the two velocity components. One, the influence I am taking it separately, and random I am taking it separately. So when you take average, the average of random becomes zero. Okay, so this drift velocity becomes equal to what? Okay, now let us talk about magnitude only, because direction is clear. So drift velocity is E magnitude of electric field by M into tau. Are you getting it?
So what happens to the negative side?
I am taking just magnitude. Okay? Now there is something amazing here, like there is a force, acceleration is there, but velocity is constant. Okay? Acceleration is there, force is there, E times E force is there, but then also your velocity is coming out to be constant. Why that happens? Because of our assumption. After every collision, velocity becomes random. Fine.